class.
Aloha.
Right, before we begin our lesson, new lesson, we're going to have a look at the handout that I just distributed. And I want you to do a simple thing. Look at it, the first paragraph, and then you're going to, yeah, first of all, pull out your pens, your pencil. And I want you to mark all the sentences that you think is a complete sentence. Yeah. All of the sentences in that paragraph. See it. So when you look at those sentences, when you combine them all, that makes a paragraph. Mm-hmm. Alright. So today our new lesson is going to be on how to write a paragraph. But first of all, I want to point out that writing a paragraph includes steps. So in order to do that, I'm going to be teaching you first, and then we're going to do it together, and then I'm going to have you do it yourself. So it's very easy step. So these are the outcomes that we're gonna cover throughout our class today. But Brother Shoot, how to bring it on the PowerPoint. Alright, I already have a backup plan here, so. These are the outcomes. Oh, right, yeah. We'll just put it on the side. What do you guys think? So, I already prepared a PowerPoint presentation. So that I can, go through step by step myself, and then we're gonna go back to those papers that I gave you. So how to write a paragraph. Interesting. All right. With the help of Cuckoo, I got all the steps that I need. So again, these are the outcomes. We will be able to write a topic sentence of a paragraph. We'll be able to demonstrate the point of the topic sentence using examples. The third one, we're gonna be able to explain the meaning of the paragraph. And the fourth one, by the conclusion. And the last one is to do the proofreading for the grammar and the organization of your paragraph. So these are the six steps. After we cover all the six steps, we're gonna be able to meet the outcomes that I just stated. First one, as I go along, you might want to take notes if you think it's really difficult to remember. Step one, you have to think about what to write. What's your topic sentence? That's the first step of the paragraph, you know. What topic am I supposed to be writing? Those are the questions that you're gonna ask yourself, right? So before putting a pencil on your paper to write a sentence, you have to come up with something in your mind. And that way you don't, you know, write with like random things that are not appropriate to your topic that the teacher gave you in your other classes. All right. Step number two, develop a topic sentence. Now it's gonna, you know, we're getting close to the put our hands on the paper, right? The main subject matter or idea converted in a paragraph. The controlling idea, this is the key word. So, the topic sentence is gonna control you all the way throughout the completing the paragraph when you write it. So the next sentence is, after the topic sentence, gonna be whole connected to the first one, controlling idea. That's why they call it the controlling idea. Step number three, demonstrate your point. So you're gonna be able to solve, right? What do you really mean? Sometimes you say something, but when you write it, you mean something else. So it's better to show it, you know, make it clear what you're trying to, you know, what you're trying to mean in your topic sentence. Right? So it's right here. What examples can I use? Again, these are, you know, a few questions that you have to ask yourself. What examples can I use to support my point? What information can I provide to help clarify my doubt? How can I support my point with specific data, experiences, or other factual material? All right, so it's kind of an interesting idea. Once you know how to write this paragraph, it's gonna help you when you come to the point where maybe the next level, next year or something, you're gonna write a reset paper, you know, essay, big essay. So, it is a little better. What information does the reader need to know in order to see my point? This one goes along with the step number three. All right, after you demonstrate your point, these are a few things that you want to include, you know, the facts, the details, the reasons, the examples, information from the reading of the classroom discussion. Well, this is a great thing. You have your your topic sentence, and then while you were writing, you thought about, oh, I learned this thing in class, you know. You can take that and put it into your paragraph. And that way, it's gonna be more specific and meaningful. Paraphrase or short quotations. Of course, you don't wanna, you know, write a big quotation, put it in your paragraph. That doesn't look good. So make sure you paraphrase it, or you avoid the long quotations. Personal experiences, stories, those are good things. Right. Well, again, what step we are talking about here? Step number three. Step number three, that's right. Moving on to step number four. give you a paragraph meaning. Well, again, we have a few questions that you're gonna have to yourself. What does the provided information mean? How does it relate to your overall point? Well, once you get the real meaning of what you're writing, because now you are at the point where, you know, you started to, I know what I'm writing. Because you are putting down your points, you know. Already. You've already put down the support examples, events. So now you know what you're writing. So make sure you know the meaning, the real meaning of what you're trying to say in your paper. And the last step, it's not the last step, but this is pretty much what the last sentence that you're gonna, include in your paragraph. You have to conclude it. Summarizing the points you have made, repeating words or phrases from the topic sentence, using linking words that indicate conclusion not being drawn. Linking words. In conclusion, this is what I'm gonna, so that the reader will know, oh, you're using the language, you are hitting your paragraph. Everyone is getting a very clear understanding right here. I hope so. Alright. The last one. Look over and proofread. Alright, so now the paragraph is already there. You've already wrote it down. Now it's the time to do the proofread. So that your teacher will how come there's too many grammatical errors to avoid those kind of problems? So you have to look at it, proofread it, so you can cross out those errors. Alright? So that's my paragraph answer, the prompt and the support my thesis. Don't really stress out on the thesis. That is just we can say it here, instead of thesis, topic sentence. Alright. Does it make sense? Does it use the appropriate academic voice? But together with this, like what I said, the grammar, the organization, All right, so before we work together on our papers that I gave it to you, the papers that you have, very good thing that you've already started writing on that. That's good. A quick review. You decide the topic of your paragraph, develop the topic sentence, demonstrate your point, But when I look at these six steps, I thought about, I need to synthesize it, make it a little bit small. It has to be in, just to get rid of the things that we don't really, need, and come up with the most. Right there?
Tomorrow,
okay.
We're gonna do it now.
Yeah, we're gonna do it now. We're gonna work on it after.
After you? After you show us how to do it? Or we do it together right now?
We're gonna do it together, and then you're gonna do it. gonna have you do it individually. And then the third one, the second part, which is writing a paragraph, we're gonna do it together. All right. I'm not saying you're gonna write it by yourself, but you just do it, and then we're gonna help each other. Can you write this like a quick sentence, and then just insert it somewhere in the paragraph where you feel like, you know, is
So can I just write about anything?
Yeah, anything that links to the something that links to the paragraph.
Okay.
Yeah. So that's how you write the paragraph. Now we can assume that you already know the whole steps and you know the whole steps with these four steps, which is the topic sentence, explanation to the topic sentence, the fact, example, and the conclusion. Any questions? Now this is an open discussion.
Yes.
So, yeah, the steps are right here.
Can we write a paragraph with any other topic? Or
any.
Okay.
Tom, what time did you finish your presentation?
14. Now we can look at our, you know, our outcomes and yes, now you know I can write a topic sentence, going down, I can write a paragraph. Good, huh? Well, thank you very much.